The Commission on Higher Education halts its cash loan program for students. Let's get more details from ABS-CBN's Robert Mano. Robert?
The Commission on Higher Education stopped implementing its program, Study Now, Pay Later, which seeks to assist college students through loans which will be paid after the graduation. During the Senate Committee on Higher Technical and Vocational Education hearing Wednesday morning, Chairperson Prospero de Vero said they opted to terminate the program because of extremely low payment rate, which was less than 10% of the total loans. It is because most of those who availed were not able to get jobs after graduation, therefore could not make enough money to pay off their loans. To replace the program, the CHED allotted 1 billion pesos under the Unified Student Financial Assistance System for tertiary education, or UNIFAS. This is similar to the University of the Philippines Loan Program, wherein the students can borrow, and if they pay it within the school year, there will be no interest. If not, they will have to pay it before they graduate. Denise.
Thanks, Robert. The Philippine Disaster Management Agency has formally recommended to President Marcos to extend the COVID state of calamity until the end of the year. That's according to Health Department Officer in Charge, Maria Rosario Vergere. The state of calamity declaration in the Philippines is set to lapse on September 13. Marcos earlier said he is keen on extending it until the end of the year.
Ang kanyang basihan was because the considerations, yung sabi natin, na mga tinitignan natin na maapektuhan pag nag-lapse ang state of calamity, yung EUA na gamit natin, yung COVID-19 vaccine deployment program, yung mga tax exemptions and all of those, sabi niya, bago natin ma-i-revisa ang RA 11525 so that we can have this cover kung sakaling mag-lapse, matatagalan pa. We cannot have this 1 month para magawa natin yon. So sabi niya, he recommends na siguro dapat i-extend na lang hanggang matapos ang taon.
The Philippine government targets to pilot test the implementation of relaxed face mask rules by the last quarter of the year. The country's COVID task force is finalizing details of the pilot test. For now, it recommends to make mask wearing voluntary, but only in outdoor settings. The optional mask wearing will only be for low-risk individuals in low-risk settings. The task force clarifies these are just recommendations for now and not a policy.
We want to emphasize the confidence of our officials sa ating bakuna, kung saan itong mga bakuna ay nakapagbigay sa atin ng patuloy na stable at manageable ang ating mga kaso ng COVID-19. And therefore, with this recommendation, the IATF recommended that there would be this optional policy for mask wearing for those low-risk individuals and in low-risk settings.
The proposed budget cut for the country's biggest COVID referral facility is set to be appealed. The Philippine General Hospital, or PGH, says it will file a petition to oppose the 200 million peso reduction in its spending plan for next year. Under the Marcos administration's budget proposal, PGH is set to receive 5.9 billion pesos in funding in 2023. This, even though it asked Congress for a 6.2 billion peso budget. PGH says government's current proposal is enough for its operations to continue. But the additional funding will be used to build a multi-special building.
Ito po ay sapat para po pangbayad sa sweldo ng ating mga healthcare workers, sa mga operating expenses po ng ospital at po yung serbisyo po na maibibigay natin sa mga pasyente nating nangangailangan. So hindi naman po yun maapektuhan. Kung kayo po ay pumunta sa PGH at kayo indigent patient, ay mabibigay po yung mga kailangan maibigay sa inyo, diagnostic test pati po paggagamot.